and the draw. Shot by Norris. Chest high save made by Jones. Now Ristolainen and Tkachuk in a bear hug. Ristolainen in a little bit of a better position as they go to the ice.
And that's the way you have to play. You have to play against this guy. And Risto's not going to shy away from trying to keep players away from his goaltender. Tkachuk's upset about it. Big, strong kid. You can see some blood there on Risto's nose. His shield probably came down and cut his nose. Look at that. I mean, that's when you're talking, JJ, about two of the more physical teams in the league, like Nashville last night. Some coincidental minor penalties along the way. You need someone to match up against that. That's where Ristolainen certainly has done his part this year. And that's a headlock right there.
So they'll talk about it while they sit in the box calmly. No mics.
He's trying to ask him to fight him, but he's not happy about that headlock. There's lots of time. Let's fight, he's saying. The kid is wild.
What I like about Risto, though, is he's a man of few words. He'll have a response, as you can see.
He's laughing.
Four words and then smile. And that just incites more emotion from Tkachuk.
This is the best.
It's a great, proactive and reactive right there.
To the main event between Forsson and Karen. A lot of trash on the ice now, so we're going to be a while before we get this one going again. Tucker has taken his spot in the penalty box. Greetings from the fans. And the majors all over the place there for those four. Let's go, Islanders is the call from this crowd here in Long Island. 1:50 left in the third period of game number six. The Islanders opened up a 2-0 lead early in the game. When Tarkowski and Yashin scored, Bielak and Hoglund tied it. A coin, a power play goal, and the only goal in the second.
Gudas really didn't like that. 1-0 Canucks, late in the second. Forehanded.
Yeah, the Vancouver power play, as you see the reaction of Radko Gudas. They got no water for him, And here's the penalty. Imore had a step. And you see the puck is way away from the players that are battling. And they call it a holding call, not interference.
She was on the wrong side of center for that puck to hit him.
This is Ryan Klo again.
Delayed penalty. 25 seconds to go in the period. Canucks should give up the puck and get the offensive zone faceoff, which they do. And Klo makes, what's his trip number five to the penalty box?
Listen to Dave Jackson. Keith Ballard goes to duck under and Klo catches him with the high stick. Up goes the arm. Mark Vlasic and Henrik Sedin. No call on that one.
And Klo being taken to the dressing room. Did he get an extra 10 maybe? I think Klo said something to Mike Hassenfratz. That didn't go over well.
Here's Ryan Klo in the penalty box, banging in the glass.
I'm sure he feels better.
Yes,
huh?
Yes.
Get a little steam up.
2 minutes for onside.
Ooh, they gave him an extra two, John, so that benefits the Canucks. It's not a 10.
Yes.
It's two for high sticking and two for unsportsmanlike.
Granstrom indirect. Chris Tierney. Wow, good wipeout check by Marchand, and apparently not. The referee down in the Bruins defensive zone making the call. I'm curious as to what it was. Trip. Leg on leg. It looked like
I thought.
Boston number 63, with the hip. Penalty tripping.
I thought it got him with the hip.
Marchand thought it was a clean hit. He certainly was looking for an open ice body contact. Big hit. Trying to lead with that right shoulder. Sure looks like he got him with the shoulder.
to get another look at it. Well, just not. I guess he did get it with the lower part of his body. Looks like the shoulder gets in there first, Jack, right?
Yes.
Right. And then the lower portion of the bodies. Attempt, and it went right to Shea Weber. Right side of your screen. Here's the move. Good, strong move there. And now as he clears it, stick is broken, and Weber finishes it.
You can see the whip in the shaft of the stick. Shea Weber's going to be able to blast it high and hard past Robin Leonard.
The reaction from the general manager, Mark Bergevin.
I'm glad. I know I'm glad I'm sitting up here now.
I think I just saw a spear, which may have started some of that problem. Hatcher threw a spear at Bourne, but look at that right hand by Hatcher.
I often sat and watched those fights as a player and stood far enough away so I wouldn't get hit with a stray one. And it's the battles like those that are really something. It's a part of the game, obviously, and to pontificate anything on that aspect of the game is incidental because it is a part of the game. And Kevin Hatcher.
Now Bourne trying to get into it with some of the spectators off to the side of the penalty box. Security guard in there trying to settle things down, but whatever got Bourne started, maybe the fan threw something. Well, the fans here have really become something in this city. They have now had 11 sellouts this year, and it looks like the rest of the way it's going to be sellout or very close to it. Let's see if we can see what happened here. Now Bourne is sitting there, and I don't see anything being thrown at him. Yes, something must have been thrown at him because he started to brush himself off. Yeah, it's verbal all the way. So, anyway, one of those games, Dan.
The front, it never got through. Great play by Letang. Pajot off the side of the goal. It's centered again off Jari. Still loose. Top four. The crowd says it's in. The referee says it's not.
And Mayfield puts Crosby right down on the seat of his pants. Good job by Rush jumping in. The energy of the crowd, Johnny. We took a pause to let the fans at home listen to the noise. The tank's got to be careful here. Now Crosby and Palmieri.
Everybody in. The Tang is incensed. Mayfield with a takedown.
That's what Dumoulin. That's more of a fair fight. Now Dumoulin's not too pleased. Lenny and Gensel, two Minnesota guys getting after one another. Pajot and Letang, two guys from the province of Quebec. It's equal opportunity here, John.
This is a game fitting for the Coliseum.
And the crowd matters, Johnny, hasn't it? The Islanders
sure
serves after the Clutterbuck goal, and
sure
so is the crowd. The Pittsburgh Penguins can ill afford to lose Letang. Gensel going after Palmieri. Can't lose your cool in these situations.
Right now, Mayfield and Wahlstrom in the Islander box.
Letang's telling Mayfield he's going to get him.
Letty and Rust. Palmieri, of course, he'll be ushered off.
And you could sense this coming right from the start of the game, Johnny, couldn't you?
Yep.
It's a playoff series against two real equal teams. And the stakes are high.
Kelly Sutherland and Garrett Rank are the referees tonight. And they will legislate all of this. Five in the box for the Islanders.
I don't know how good a trade-off this is for the Penguins. Look
right
at some of the artillery that's in there. And if Dumoulin's going in too, that's a problem.
There are four in the box right now as we see. Rust, Letang, Crosby, and Gensel.
And if Dumoulin's going in, you lost your top five guys.
And he is. He's going to have his say.
That's a great trade for the Islanders.
Oh boy, who gets to stand here? How do they figure that
the young
one out?
Guys. The young guys got to stand. The old guys get to sit.
Well, Wahlstrom is comfortable.
Joe goes back across off the skate of Zach Parise.
John, that's the 12th blocked shot for the Islanders in this game.
Yeah, we got some penalties coming up here as Pageau and Zegras are tangled up with one another, and the officials say both of you. You know, take a couple minutes to think.
It was a real late call from the official, and I don't think he was going to call anything. It's going to be a trip against Zegras and an interference penalty against Pageau.
There's the interference.
There's the interference, but there was no call at that point.
There's the slew foot.
And there's the trip by Zegras. So no call at that point as Zegras is trying to get to a loose puck. And you see Zegras complaining. And then Pageau takes a little bit of a dive in my mind. And they both go and Zegras is going, you got to be kidding me. Can you look at the video, please?
He and Pageau are going to have a couple of minutes to discuss this. So as is the case with Trevor Zegras, there's always a discussion. And it will be ongoing as the play continues. 4-on-4.